Yeah, there's something I wanted to talk to you about. Yeah, I know. I've been a little distant lately. I've been reading a lot. I've been soul searching. I've been trying to find myself. And I think I found myself. I think I figured things out. I do. I seem more calm and centered. Yeah, I do. I've been practicing mindfulness. I've been meditating every day. Yeah, I've been trying to have less coffee. I mean, look at this. This is really big. But you know what? One coffee a day is okay, right? Yeah. I know it's important to eat a certain way as well when you're going through an awakening. I know. Anyways, listen, there's something I want to talk to you about, and I think this pertains to you as well. Okay. Have you heard of Dolores Cannon and her three waves of volunteers? No? Okay. Well, I know. It sounds weird already. Okay. I know. I don't want to lose you already. I know you don't like when I get too esoteric and too spiritual, but here we go. So there's three waves of volunteers that have come to the earth in the form of humans. Okay. So humans have been born, and what happens in life is that, wait, let me start again. Okay. So we all know that everybody is made of energy, right? And we have a spiritual side to us. And we also have a physical side. Okay. So there's those two, there's the duality, the two aspects, right? So the physical side is the physical body, and the spiritual side is the soul. Okay. So everybody's soul, you know, if you believe, they reincarnate over and over again and live lives over and over again as humans. And we learn certain lessons in life, and there's karma that we carry with us over and over again from life to life to life until we can like get rid of that karmic debt, right? Well, there's some people that Dolores Cannon, after doing a lot of regressive therapy, so she did like hypnosis so she could find out. Am I talking too fast? Okay, sorry. I got excited. You know me. I get excited. Okay, I'll slow down. So she does this kind of hypnosis with people, and she talks to their actual spirit as it goes through their different lives. So she can find the spirit in a certain life and ask them about it. So she noticed more and more in the recent times, people that have come to Earth for the first time. So souls that have come to Earth for the first time, to be human for the first time, which is very, it can be very stressful for the very delicate soul. Okay, now here, this is the cool part. Apparently there's been three sets of souls that have come at different waves or different bunches or different time periods. Okay, so the first wave would be people that are like in their 50s to 70s right now. They're seen as like highly sensitive. They don't like violence. They can't really handle intense emotions because they've always been like a spirit. They've been light and airy and able to kind of flit and fleet around very easily and not be weighed down by this heavy body with all of these hormones and neurotransmitters and all this stuff that happens in a human body. You know, and they're used to peace and love and all of that. So like those people right now would be like between 50 and 70. So you probably know some people who are like that. Like these people get really like, I guess you could say it makes them feel very depressed and they miss home. They want to go home and they don't even necessarily know what that means. And some people in that group even try to commit suicide out of this desperate need to like get away from all this and let it be easier for them. Okay, so that was the first wave, okay? The second wave would have been like my generation. So that would be like, people would be in their like late 30s and 40s right now. And that wave of people came and it was easier for them, although still difficult, okay? So, you know, that first wave kind of treaded the fresh snow, and then we came in, and my job, you know, or, you know, anybody who considers themselves a second wave volunteer, all we really have to do is be here and have this good energy to us where we can light up a room just by walking in. Or when people want to be around us, we attract like these people who kind of have like either a lack of energy or a negative energy, and they want to kind of balance it out. But we have like this positive, this overall positive vibration, an increase in the vibration of the earth just by being here. That's the job of the second wave volunteer. It's just to be here, you know? And like we're like, she would call us an antenna, a beacon, a generator, or a channeler of energy. It's amazing. You know, learning about this kind of role that I have makes me realize that I have fulfilled my ultimate purpose, in a sense, just by being here on Earth, right? I mean, it feels really great. Like, does this resonate with you at all? Like, yeah? So you do feel like, you know what? I'm gonna tell you how you know if you are, common traits of people that are second wave, okay? So you'll know for sure, okay? I know, I don't wanna freak you out. I'm almost done. I'm gonna tell you about the third wave, and then I wanna tell you common traits of the second wave, okay? So the third wave are, right now they're like older children. They could be like anywhere as young as like 10 or 12, up to like 20, and they have the knowledge already. They're already genetically upgraded beyond what we were, like on a human level, okay? So, you know, they might be seen as having ADHD in school or some other kind of, you know, attention deficit type issues because they get bored at school because they're actually, you know, advanced beyond like, you know, children that are in that karmic cycle, right? With their souls. Okay, so I can get more into that like next time we meet for coffee. I'm just gonna have a little sip. You wanna go get a coffee before I continue? You're okay? You're really into this. Okay, cool. Okay, now I wanna tell you like things that are common between people that are second wave, okay? Not everybody has all of these things, but I thought of you, okay? The first thing is that commonly people that are second wave are considered highly sensitive or like introverted. They're considered empathic, okay? So, or they're like an empath by nature, okay? So you absorb others' energies. You can sense how other people feel, right? So I mean, you kind of struggle with that because you kind of take other people's baggage, right? So I mean, yeah, totally resonates with me, and I thought of you too. The second thing is that we commonly, and this is not in any particular order, we commonly have green eyes. And green eyes are associated with like a smaller percentage of the population, only like 2% of people in the world have green eyes. And I thought that was really neat because it's not a dominant eye color, it's recessive eye color. So if your mom or your dad had green eyes and the other one didn't, you're likely to not have green eyes. I have green eyes, and so does my twin sister, so does my mom, so do you, look at that. Interesting. Okay. The next thing is that commonly they're people that are of multiple births. So they're a twin, a triplet, or even more, right? You don't have to be, but I mean, commonly the first twin was, you know, the first sibling was there to be born. And the second one, upon being created, when the cell split, the second soul came in as a volunteer, which I think is so cool because I've always felt different. I've always felt like I had a different purpose. I thought I was an earth angel for the longest time, and maybe I am, but you know, maybe you and me were both second wave volunteers with this higher purpose, which is amazing, just to raise the vibration of the earth. Next thing I find or that I've learned is similar among people of second wave is that we have dreams where we are flying or free of the body, right? So you're flying, you're jumping high, you're swimming, right? Like there's like an ocean where you can swim, where you're not confined to the gravity. You're not forced by gravity to be confined to the ground. I dreamt about this so many times. I've had lucid dreams of being able to fly, and I'm always flying in my dreams. I don't know, like it's this light, easy feeling where it's almost like I'm at home when I'm doing that. And I love that. The next thing is that we're commonly somewhat uncoordinated with the hand-eye coordination, the gross motor skills, a little bit clumsy. You're just not used to this physical body yet because it's the first time you've kind of inhabited one. I find I'm terrible at sports. My worst sport is volleyball. Yours too? Oh my God, isn't it the worst when the ball's coming to you and you just don't, you're like a weirdo, you know? Like that's what I feel like, a weirdo. And everyone else seems to love volleyball, and it's like, ugh. I don't get it. I mean, I'm not competitive at all by nature either, so I don't know if that's part of it. But another thing is this personality of being the INFJ, okay? So there's the introvert, You know, from the 16 personalities. So it's like, I'm an introvert, I'm judging, but meaning I'm not judging, but you know what being INFJ makes you, again, it goes with the highly sensitive, it goes with the introvertedness, it goes with the being empathic, it goes with sensing others' emotions. And the biggest thing I find with being INFJ is that I don't need to experience something to understand it. I can understand it just from you telling me how you feel or what happened to you. I can feel the same feelings. And other people, sympathy is different than empathy, right? Another thing is that people commonly are very creative that are second wave. And again, like my I love to make and create and do things and make things, something out of nothing. I feel like that's something that I'm called to do, especially when it makes other people happy. That makes me really happy. Two more things. One of them is that we're often our blood is Rh negative, which is also associated with a smaller percentage of the population. And I'll get into that another time, what that could mean. And the last thing that I wanted to tell you guys about is... we're very generous, loving, and kind. And that's why I thought of you, because you are a beautiful soul. You're perfect the way you are, and I love how you are. And that's why I'm so glad you met with me today. I'm so glad you sat down with me and I had coffee, and you haven't even had a coffee yet. You're gonna go get a coffee? Okay, you go get your coffee. I'm just gonna say something here on my, I'm just gonna pick up my phone here and make a quick call, okay? All right, go get the coffee, okay. Okay, guys, while my friend's going to get a coffee, no. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please hit that like button, hit that subscribe button, and hit the bell notification so you don't miss the next one. I'd love to talk much, much more about these three waves. It has blown my mind, and I hope it blows your mind too. So please leave a comment. Any questions, any comments, any concerns, any suggestions, anything like that. I love your comments, and I love to interact with you. I love you all so much. I'm sending you tons of love and light to all of you. Have the most wonderful, most beautiful, blessed day of your life. Mwah. I love you.